Hi, my name is Charlotte. I love colorful and sparkly makeup. I also love seasonal makeup, and today I'm going to be building a custom fall palette. I do apologize for any outside sounds you might hear, but it's a nice day and I'm over here by my window. People are out and about. I did a custom palette on my channel a little while ago for like some late summer colors, and I know that video went on for a million years, so I'm gonna try my best not to talk through everything this time so that I'll have some footage to speed up. I want today's palette to be inspired by autumn leaves. So I'm thinking about like some sort of muted, fading kind of greens, some of those maroon and reddish tones that you get in leaves, but I don't want the palette to be Christmassy. So I'm like, that's what I'm worried about happening. So I'm gonna try to lean on some like yellows and oranges to bring it back to the autumnal color palette. And as I'm going through these shades, I am thinking about like, what's the right balance of mattes, shimmers, lid shades, inner corner shades, all of that. I'm still learning how to build custom palettes actually, which like I guess I didn't think of that as a skill before, like to actually build the anatomy of a custom palette. What is it that you actually need in practice, and how do you distribute the colors you're interested in among those different elements? So that's what I'm thinking about when I'm pulling shades, and I might end up, doing a call at the end. The other thing is I don't have a lot of shifty shades in my collection at the moment. I have ordered some shifty shades, I will admit, so I'm really looking forward to playing with those. And I think like in custom palettes that I see on Instagram and YouTube, shifts are a really interesting and fun way to tie in different colors. My shades are not gonna have a ton of shifts in them, so what that means is that I can't have like a red and a green in the same shade, so I'm gonna need to use two shades to get in that red and that green, if that makes sense. But I am gonna try and stick to 12 shades. I actually recently depotted and magnetized my Dirty Martini palette from Glamlight. I had to re-pan a few shades too, so I know this would drive some people crazy, so sorry if this like makes you uncomfortable, but I actually don't mind having different pan shapes and sizes, and I'm so psyched to have this packaging magnetized because I think it's really cute, but it kind of just like has the perfect feel to me for a palette. It feels just really satisfying. Like it snaps shut. I love it. So I'm gonna treat myself to building this palette in here.
Mm-hmm.
There's two old men hanging out on one of the balconies across the street from me, so if you hear them talking, just know that they're having a really nice afternoon. Anyway, this is the long list. I'm gonna start sorting these by order of like how easy the decision is. So to start, I know I want to keep this yellow. It's important, I think, for making the palette feel autumnal rather than Christmassy. It's not as mustard as I would like, but I think I can always mix it with this to get something a little grungier. And I also know that I want to put this brown transition in the palette. For other mattes, I wanted to have two deepening shades, one red and one green. And I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna go with this red. This is from the Main Squeeze palette from ColourPop. I wanted a maroon that would like really lean red rather than pink. For the green shade, I have a couple options that I think are basically dupes for each other. This is Eucalyptus from Beauty Bay Earthy Palette. This is from the, I think this is called Dry Vermouth. It's from, am I saying that right? Vermouth. It's from the Dirty Martini palette. I just repanned it. And I think that the Beauty Bay one is a little deeper, so I'm gonna go with that one. I thought maybe I would have room for like a mid-toned green transition, but I don't think I'm going to, but I'm just gonna put those to the side for now. Yeah, and same for the red. I don't think I'll have room for like a mid-toned red matte, so I'm gonna put that to the side for now. Moving on to oranges, I also know that I need oranges in this palette to make it look autumnal, so I pulled out a few. This is from the Earthy palette. I think it's called Squash. Kind of light. I also pulled this one from the It's a Mood palette. It's called It's a Rush. This is ColourPop. And this is like, it's a little more red toned than I realized. So that's giving me a little bit of pause. Otherwise, I would go for that like level of depth. This is also from It's a Mood and it's called Crave You. It's a transition tone, so like I don't need it because I have this warm brown, but it does look like more obviously orange than this reddish toned one, so I'm torn. This is almost a deepening shade for me because I have a light skin tone and I just like my taste. I don't prefer things to look super deep on me, so but I am inclined to go with this one just because I have this warm brown that, like, let's see, I think it's gonna be too similar to these oranges, but it's like it's not orange enough to like make the palette into a palette with orange in it, if this makes sense. So yeah, I'm gonna go with this for now until further notice. I'll change it out if I have to. Okay, now we get to look at some shimmers. I also definitely know that I want to keep this red. This is just far and away right now my favorite red in my collection. This is from Glam Shop. It's called Na Ostro, which I think means spicy. And it's quite an orange toned red. Yeah, it's like a nice autumnal rusty color. I'm also pretty sure I want to put this copper in. This is the copper shade from the Nearly Natural palette from Glaminatrix. I feel like it's the best orange shimmer I have. I don't really like the color orange that much, so I don't have that many orange shimmers. All like the closest thing I have is copper, so and this is the best copper I have, so I'm gonna go with this for now. Right, this one's slightly harder. I'm pretty sure I want to put this in the palette. This is Wanna Go from It's a Mood. This is a very rich tarnished bronze shade, and it's so smooth and satiny that it almost functions like a matte. And I just really want to play around with this more and see what I can do with this kind of finish. And also, I just really like this tone. However, it's really close to this shade Folklore, or at least I'm worried it's going to be too close. Oh, Folklore's a lot more green. Folklore is from the Earthy palette. It's just such a nice tone, and I've been like kind of waiting. I've been looking forward all year to just using this in the autumn because I think it's just so autumnal and pretty, and I feel like that would be, not that I can't use it if it's not in my autumn palette, but you know what I mean. I mean, I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna keep this out because they're not too similar, and I'm gonna move the bronze into the short list. I'm pretty sure I can narrow down these golds. I should keep out a swatch of this bronze because it's kind of a dark gold. I like dark golds. If I'm gonna wear a gold, I like a dark gold. This is the one I'm leaning toward. It's from the Dirty Martini palette. I don't remember. I haven't labeled these yet, so I don't remember what it's called, but it's the gold in that palette. And it has like a bit of a green shimmer to it. And it's also got like a redness in the base. So I think it's actually perfect for this palette because it's marrying the red, the green, the yellowy gold. So I'm pretty sure I want to keep this in. But I have a lot of other golds, and like I thought about just having a straight true gold, but I kind of don't think I need one anymore. These ones are from the Earthy palette. Those are similar. That's like a shinier version of Wanna-Go. Oh, what a beautiful tone. Like, yeah, that really is my favorite kind of gold. But yeah, I don't think I need any of these other golds in the palette. I'm gonna keep this greenish leaning one, and I'm gonna keep that bronze. Actually, before I wipe these off, I did wanna try. This is Kava from the Earthy palette, and this was in my long list of potential inner corner highlights. It's got like almost a silvery sheen on top of a gold. Okay, Kava's quite different from all these golds. I'm gonna move on to swatching some inner corner highlights. So here's Kava. Here's Satellite, which is a silvery green. And here is Ray, which is a very light sheer gold with a green shift. I love the shade Ray with a burning passion, as you can probably see. I recently hit pan on this and I'm like actually scared I'm gonna finish it, which is obviously stupid because like I've clearly like the vast majority of this still remains in the pan. But that's how I always kind of feel when I hit pan on a shade that I really love. I'm trying to like train myself out of feeling that way, but okay, I think I'm gonna put this in the palette. As for these, I've really been enjoying using Satellite as an inner corner highlight for like cool toned, desaturated, tealish, autumnal looks. I don't know that it's gonna fit with the vibe of this whole palette. I think Kava is closer, but it still has like a little bit of a cool sheen on it, which is kind of adds a little interest. So I think I'm gonna keep Kava. This is the shade Tombok from Glam Shop. It's like a, oh wow, there was like a little clump of purple there. So yeah, this has like a purplish, taupish, brownish base on it. I consider this to be kind of a taupe shade, but it does have sparkles over top that are kind of gold, kind of green. So I think this would add something kind of interesting to the palette because of the gold and green. It does have a cool toned base, so it doesn't fit exactly with the vibe of the palette, but I think it would add something different that might be kind of interesting. So I think I'm gonna keep it around for now. Okay, and finally, I have some green shimmers to go through, and this is kind of challenging for me because I love my green shimmers. Let's see how many I have so far. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 12. I feel like there's room in this palette. In my heart, there's room for 2 green shimmers. So there's Folklore. It's a bit smoother, not the most sparkly formula, but a really beautiful muted green. This is from Dirty Martini. I think it's called Vodkatini, maybe. That's got a much brighter lime shimmer on top. Let's see. Gabriel from Odin's Eye. A little bit more blue based. But this doesn't have as much dimensionality as the Glam Light shade. And then finally, this one's called Olive Lover, I believe. It's It's much deeper. And it's a cooler toned green as well. It has like a little bit of blue shimmer running over top. I love that shade so much. It's so interesting. Damn, I'm really torn. I don't want the green to be too bright because I want it to be like that kind of faded green. So that really fits the bill for that. This one might be a little bit too bright, even though I love this shade. Honestly, I kind of want all three. I kind of want all three. I'm gonna see where I'm at. I think I'm gonna boot this cool toned green. I think it's too cool for the palette. And I'm thinking about booting this for the same reason. That would give me 13. So I swatched out a few potential looks on my hand, and I think I'm gonna make a risky decision and actually remove this warm brown transition shade and instead replace it with this orangey brown transition shade. I think on the eyes, this will look somewhat brown, but it still adds that orange element I wanted in the palette. And I figured that if I really want something more brown toned to blend out, say like this shade or this shade, I can try using this as like a semi matte kind of shade. I'm honestly curious if that will work. So I'm thinking like these could be a look altogether with either inner corner shade. This gold could pair well with this green on the outer lid, or it could pair with this red on the outer lid, or with this orangey copper on the outer lid. And then, you could deepen with red. You could blend out the red with orange. Could put this all over the lid and top it with one of these more like coppery shades. Although here's the question, do I actually need both these oranges? Probably not. It makes the palette as a whole look slightly less autumnal, but oh, that's 12. What am I talking about? I don't really have room for another one. Okay, I'm pretty happy with this, I think. Let's put it into the palette. Okay, here is the final palette. I tried to arrange it the way Catherine B. Beauty does, where she tries to have each row, each column, and each quad be a potential cohesive look. I don't think I succeeded. That is like Sudoku, and it was too much for my brain. So I've just put them kind of in a random layout here, and I'm gonna swatch them out, and we'll see where we are. So here's the palette swatched. I have to say, this isn't like the perfect autumn leaf color story of my dreams. I think I made a lot of sacrifices for the sake of having like the right transition tones, the right deepening tones. I'll be interested to see how this works in practice and what these looks end up coming out like. I'm cautiously optimistic. Actually, you know what? I think I was thrown a bit by how vibrant this yellow is. So I just kind of layered it with some of this warm brown and got like more of a mustard tone. I think that I'll be able to do the same thing by mixing it with the orange, like on the eyes. So I do like it a lot better with that mustard tone. So I ended up changing my mind. I added three new shades. I was watching back the footage and I loved how the color story was looking. Like, I thought it was just really satisfying to look at until I moved the mid-toned green mattes off the screen, and then I was like just less inspired by the rest of it without those shades. So I think that's why I was like feeling a little bit meh about the color story by the end of the palette building. But yeah, this is a couple of days later and I added back this matte and I just feel like it doesn't totally look like a fading leaf color, but I mean, like, it's September, like we're in that time of year where the orange and red leaves are going to be coexisting with the bright green leaves. So, whatever. I just like the color story a lot more when this color is added. And then I ended up just adding two more to make it 15. So I put Tombac back in, and then I just added like a dark brown, because why not? Yeah, so ultimately, I think like I ended up making choices about how I wanted this palette to look as a palette. Like, not like these things don't necessarily add like function that I needed in the palette, but it just makes me feel more inspired when I like look down at all these pans together. And I think that's valid too. And I also decided that 12 pans is too ambitious for me. I think I'm gonna just build 15 pan palettes for a while until I feel like I'm a little better at this, because I don't know about you guys, but I find it like surprisingly challenging to build a palette that works on every level and that is inspiring to look at as well. So that's the video. I hope this was inspiring to watch in some way and that you are having a great time playing around with your fall eyeshadows. And I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye!